Welcome back to The Morning Brew.
We're now joined by Ninet, who's going to be performing her new single, Self-Destructive Mind. So take it away, Ninet.
Thank you so much.
All right. When you wake up in the middle of the night, am I still on your mind? 'Cause times are changing, and do you have a friend or someone to talk to? You keep it all to yourself. You keep it all to yourself. Destructive mind. Don't let anyone cut down the wire. I'm still waiting for you to come clean. And I know, yes, I know you're so tired. And I will let you in, I'll let you in, I will let you in. I'll let you in, I'll let you in, I'll let you in. Two birds hanging on the wire of hope, elusive denial, 'cause times are changing. And I'm trying so hard not to forget everything you told me. I keep it all to myself. I keep it all to myself. I keep it all to myself. Destructive mind. Don't let anyone cut down the wire. I'm still waiting for you to come clean. And I know, yes, I know you're so tired. And would you let me in? 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 Self-destructive mind. Don't let anyone cut down the wire. I'm still waiting for you to come clean. And I know, yes, I know you're so tired. Oh, self-destructive mind. Don't let anyone cut down the wire. I'm still to come clean. And I will let you in, I'll let you in, I will let you in, I will let you in, I'll let you in, I will. Thank you. Thank you so much.
The year was 1938, and the U.S. sat on the brink of another world war. The American people looked for diversion from the trials and tribulations of a new century and its new problems. In 1940, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt authorized the release of an entirely new form of entertainment.
Today, a hope of many years' standing is in large part fulfilled.
It was called the Trojan Visual and Auditory Mimeograph Device, or Trojan Vision for short. As bombs fell and war was waged, society tuned to 8.1 for relief. Throughout American history, Trojan Vision has shown us the moments of America's triumphs, spreading the finest programming throughout Greater Los Angeles and worldwide online. Watch Trojan Vision and see history being made.
And welcome back to the Morning Brew. We're going to use our breaking news button again because we have Ninet with us and we have some breaking news. Your show just got sold to Netflix.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank
That's
you.
Huge. Tell us
Thank
a little
you.
Bit about that.
Oh my God. Where should I begin? It's a show that we shot in Israel and in Colombia. It's called When Heroes Fly. And the role that I'm playing there, her name is Yaeli. And it's a such a beautiful story about courage and friendship and of course, the PTSD. I don't know how much you know about it, but it's like, it's a big, big issue in Israel and, of course, worldwide. So I think we just got the news and we're so happy and excited. I'm like, ah, Netflix is going to be amazing.
Yeah, we had someone from 13 Reasons Why a few weeks back, and they said that working at Netflix is the greatest experience. So I'm sure you're going to love it.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm excited.
Yeah, I'm sure you are.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So what is your role in this?
My role, her name is Yaeli. I don't know how much I can tell, actually, because it's like a complicated story where I don't want to ruin, for anyone. The show starts when I'm basically dead.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So where do you go from there?
Exactly, you know? Yeah. It's kind of tricky, but that's, I think, the most, like, this is so interesting because once the show starts like this, so you're like, okay, so what's going to happen next? For me, it was such a great pleasure to work with the cast and the director, of course, and just to shoot it. It took me a long time to just snap out of this role because it was so, like, emotional.
Yeah.
You guys should see it.
Oh, I can't wait.
And then I'll come visit again, and then we can talk about it more freely, you know?
Well, let's talk about the reason why you're here is that your music is really doing fantastic. We just heard you sing your new song, Self-Destructive Mind.
Yeah.
So how is it going? How is the music industry? You're originally from Israel, so how is it now coming here and transferring the music over to the States?
I just moved, I moved here 2 years ago from Israel, and at the beginning it was like, okay, what am I doing here? What am I doing, like, in general? Is this the right move? And Self-Destructive Mind was written just a few months after me and my family were moved here. And I just remember I was sitting in my balcony and I was thinking, okay, is this the right move to do? Am I in the right place? And, you know, we all have this, like, conversation in our mind between us and ourselves. It's the doubt.
Right.
If I can say, it's like the doubt that, like, constantly you're no good, you're not doing the right thing, you're gonna fail, you know. So I decided to write a song about it. I mean, I didn't decide, it just happened. I just went to my room, I picked up the guitar, and this song just came out. And now I can say that I feel good, like today. but you know, it's kind of difficult because it's like to relocate to a new place with no family, no friends, no nothing, just like move and start over, which is also, it's a good thing, but you know, it's tough.
Yeah. So what is the difference between life in Israel and life in LA?
Oh my God. For me, it's a big difference because here, I mean, in Israel, I have successful career, thank God, still. And when I decided to move here, it was like, okay, I need to taste, like, the, you know, new culture, new people, and to be creative and, you know, to get out of my comfort zone and to try to be better and better each and every day. That's why I decided to move here. And the big difference for me is just that I can, like, go on the street with, like, you know, everything's cool. no one here. It's so cool. Mm-hmm. And yeah, to just experience everything from the top. It's great.
Yeah, well, some similarities between here and Israel is that we have American Idol here. There they have Israeli Idol, which you won. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, yeah, it was 15 years ago. In Israel, actually, the Israeli version called A Star Is Born.
Oh, really? Oh.
Really funny, yeah. Now that the Lady Gaga movie is like, I know, it's like, okay, I feel familiar.
I was in that too.
Yeah, kind of, but yeah, the literal, like, it's like A Star Is Born. Uh-huh. So in Israel, it happened 15 years ago. Yeah, I was 19, I was young, I'm still young. I want to believe, but yeah, it was very, very overwhelming because it all happened like in just one night, and ever since I'm just working in music, and you know, for me it's the best thing because that's what I love to do the most.
Wow.
So yeah, in general, I feel very grateful, you know, in my life, the place I'm in, just there's always like, you know, hard times, and but it's all good. That's life.
100%.
But you need to like overcome, and you know, just as I say earlier, be better and better each and every day.
Yeah, and that's what makes you relatable.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Now, do you have any shows coming up anywhere that we can come see you?
I will have.
You will?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let us know when you do, because
of
we definitely want to get our students out to see you, because
Perfect.
It's so amazing. Your songs are incredible.
Thank you.
But where can people find that song, Self-Destructive Mind?
You can find it on iTunes, Spotify, anywhere. Basically anywhere.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool. Yeah. And where can we follow you?
On Instagram. Instagram, it's n.tayeb, and Facebook, it's Ninet Tayeb, official. And yeah, follow me.
Yeah, absolutely. And then watch her Netflix show.
Oh,
do we know
so
when that's
excited.
Coming? Any like, do we know any like estimate?
January.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
soon.
Quick.
Yeah. It's like
start of the
now.
Year.
Yeah.
Very
yeah.
sick.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show
thank
this
you.
Morning. Thank you all for watching, and catch us next Monday on the Morning Brew.
Bye, guys.
The year was 1938, and the U.S. sat on the brink of another world war.